हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद ग्रामर चैप्टर 4 ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स। सो बिफोर वी बिगिन, व्हाट आर ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स? दे आर आल्सो कॉल्ड हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स। ओके, सो दे डू नॉट हैव अ मीनिंग ऑन देयर ओन। दे हेल्प द मेन वर्ब्स टू फॉर्म इन फॉर्मिंग अ सेंटेंस। एंड इफ वी यू राइट ओनली द हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स, दे विल हैव नो मीनिंग। दे नीड द मेन वर्ब टू फॉर्म meaning and a grammatical sentence. Now, why do we use these verbs? What are the functions of these auxiliary verbs? So the first one is to form questions. Okay, so when we are forming questions, we replace the auxiliary with a subject. So for example, I can help you, right? So can is an auxiliary verb, so we replace it with subject. Can I help you? Okay, then the second one is to form short answers. That is, you don't really have to complete the whole sentence in the say the whole sentence in the answer. You can just say the auxiliary verb and done. So for example, will you be here on time? Yes, I will. You don't have to say I will be here on time. If you just say I will, it will work. Then we use it to avoid repetition. Okay, so for example, bring all that you can bring. Okay, so instead of writing bring two times, we will just write bring all that you can. Okay, it explains that you have to bring everything that you can bring. Then we use them to form question tags. Okay, so isn't it, can't you, weren't they? So these are question tags and auxiliary verbs. Then the last function is when a statement does not have an auxiliary verb or forms of be and have as main verbs, we use the auxiliary do in the question tag. Okay, so when we are making a question tag, writing the sentence in the form of a question tag, and we do not have an auxiliary verb in the form of be or have, we write do. Okay, don't you, didn't they, etc. And other than that, the various uses of auxiliary verbs are to make sentences in past perfect tense, to make the sentences in past continuous tense, in passive, make the sentences in passive, then to express an obligation. Okay, that means you must do this, you mustn't do that. Then to make a question. Okay, now we have divided these auxiliary verbs in three groups. Okay, so the first one is the primary or main auxiliary verb. So now, how do we use these primary or main auxiliary verbs, and what are these primary and main auxiliary verbs? So they are be, have and do. So first we will look at be. How do we use be? We use it in ing forms. Okay, when we are making sentences in continuous tenses. So she is playing basketball in the garden. She is playing. Playing is the main verb and is the main auxiliary verb. Correct? And then we use it with be plus a past participle. When do we use this? When we are making the sentences in passive form. So the shop was closed. Closed is the main verb and was is the primary auxiliary verb. Okay. Then the second one is have. When do we use have? It is used when we are making sentences in perfect tense. Okay. So she has never worked before. Okay. So over here has been used to make present perfect tense. Similarly, we can use it to make a past perfect tense sentence as well. Okay, so moving on, we have do. Now, how do we use the main auxiliary verb do? It can be used to form negatives of the simple present and past tense forms. So we can make negative sentences of simple present and past tense form by using do. So he does not dance very well. Does not is the main auxiliary verb, right? Then do is used to form questions in the simple present and past tense forms. Okay, to form questions. I want some tea. Do you want some tea? Like that. Next, we use it when we are forming questions in the simple present or past tense. So, for example, what did Karan say? Where does Nikhil keep his important papers? Right? And do is also used to show emphasis. That means you want to give more importance to something from that sentence. So, he does seem very tired. Okay, so we are putting emphasis on tired. So, we are using does. Okay. Then the second form is modals or modal auxiliary verbs. Now, when do we use these modal auxiliary verbs? Are used before the main verb and they express ability, possibility, certainty, suggestion, permission, obligation, etc. Okay. So, for example, ability is represented by can. Then possibility, past ability is represented by could. Then permission is represented by the word may. Okay. May I do this? May I go there? Similarly, request is also represented by could. Could you do me a favor? Right? Then, etc. Then we have other auxiliary verbs with characteristics of modals. Okay, so these are auxiliary verbs which have the characteristics of modals. That means they represent permission, certainty, request, etc. Therefore, they are also called semi-modals. Okay, and now they're made up of two or more separate words. Okay, so for example, be able to, need to, be likely to, have to, ought to, etc. Okay, and for example, if we are using it in a sentence, it would be Rashi wouldn't dare disobey me. Wouldn't dare is the main verb. So wouldn't disobey is the wouldn't, and disobey is the modal auxiliary, semi-modals, right? Then, unlike modals, these often change their form according to the subject and may have a full range of tenses. Okay. So that means we were able to get in to see the film. So over here the subject is we. Right. So now if we replace we with something else, I. So the form of the verb were will change. We will write I was able to get in to see the film. Okay, so the form of the semi-modal changes with the subject and even with tenses. Okay, so if we're converting it from present tense to past tense, the semi-modal form will change. Okay, then we use these other auxiliary verbs to form negative sentences. Okay, we attach, and not is attached to the auxiliary verb that comes after the subject and not to the semi-modal phrase. Okay, the one that comes after. So, for example, we weren't able to get the tickets for the trip. Weren't. Okay, so we have attached not to weren't, and weren't comes after the subject we. And then we use them to form questions. And here we replace it with the subject. So, for example, weren't we able to get the tickets for the trip? Okay.